I'm exhausted.
Wow.
Man, I worked
up a
sweat.
Let me just fix this.
I've never been in the kennel before.
Man.
I have been in the doghouse before, and I probably just got right back in there. As you can tell, this ain't going to be a normal night. There's no play-by-play guy here to keep us under control. Just two guys talking ball with my buddy Franford Schiller, just a couple of analysts with a terrific product on the floor in front of us in the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
I can't wait to see the Zags. The best offensive team in the country. Seven guys in double figures. Killian Tilly's back in the lineup, Jimmy. And we're gonna see a team. We'll dissect them all night. Can this team get to a Final Four? I think the answer right off the bat is yes, they can.
Yeah, I'm with you. The best offensive team I've seen all year. The numbers back it up. Wow, the kennel has delivered. Fran, this is a heck of a ball game now. The last two times these two teams played, San Francisco led for 26 minutes. They got good guard play. They have to make threes tonight, coming in shooting about 22% in the last five games, and there's their starters.
Yeah, keep your eye on Jabari Bouye. Mark Few told us he gives them a problem. He's a tremendous athlete.
Not Bouye, Bouye.
The last thing that Dons want to do when they come in here, Jimmy, is turn the ball over.
Absolutely.
On the first possession.
And Gonzaga, the only team in the country with the seven guys in double figures. They can all light you up. And for the Zags, they're starting five and pretty consistent with Woolridge, Ayayi, Kispert, Tilly, and Petrushev. Frank Gonzaga, solid defensively, not great, solid.
Yeah, they got to be better, I think, over the course of the season. They're 35th in the country. Not good enough, I think, to win a national title. That's one thing you cannot do if you're Todd Golden, this terrific young coach, is getting your big guys in foul trouble. Jimbo Lull is a handful inside for Mark Few and his Zags, but he was in foul trouble last game.
The ball's going to go inside tonight for Gonzaga. In the first matchup, 45 twos were made in the game by Gonzaga. They pounded inside, and pound away again.
Yeah, high-low is the big thing for them. And this kid's getting better and better. Petrushev, sophomore from Serbia. This USF team will spread you out. Their guards are quick. They're going to try to make Gonzaga guard all over the floor.
And I mentioned that number by USF. They're 10-0 this year when they're shooting 34% or better from the three-point line. They have struggled the last five games. Talking to Todd Golden, who looks like the student manager, he's actually the head coach. He said, we've been getting open looks, just haven't been dropping them in. And you know as well as I do, when you're shooting, selection is not good. That number drops, but they've been getting good looks. Well, how hard is he to guard? Huh?
Yep.
How hard? He is a 6'11 guard, and that's how you have to defend him. You can switch 1-4 on him, but his ability, Fran, to stroke it from three and do that off the bounce, my goodness, hard to guard.
Keep in mind, in that last game that San Francisco led, he did not play. So you're getting a chance to see Killian Tilly.
Man, the speed of Woolridge. Wow. I was watching on the far side of the floor. Woolridge in a dead sprint. His speed on offense and especially defensively, I think, has changed Gonzaga this year.
Mark Few said he's not going to be the WCC Player of the Year, but he really should get some consideration. He's changed their team when you think about who they lost. 79% of their points.
Man, Gonzaga. They are sitting in a stance. They're talking on their ball screen. They're icing stuff on the side. This is what you talked about, Fran. You turn that thing over in this building, and the kennel starts barking loud. The speed of Woolridge, man, bam, zip.
Yeah. I'm watching him play this year, Jimmy. He's a Dallas kid.
Uh-huh.
I think he's as fast as any of the fast guards in the country. I would throw Devon Dotson in there.
Yep.
You know, maybe Hagans.
Hagans got good speed.
Yep.
Yeah, this kid is right there with him in that area.
Transfer from North Texas, UNT. Oh, good effort by this kid. Coonan is an Australian freshman. And, of course, Todd Golden, a terrific point guard at St. Mary's, where they had that pipeline, but he's starting that international pipeline for USF.
And he is so skilled, Tilly is. That high-low set, when he's the high guy, not only is he a three-point shooter, but a drive threat as well.
Do you remember the scouting report we watched yesterday?
Yeah, we watched it.
They didn't think he could drive from the top.
Well, they haven't been watching the right film. That dude is as skilled as any 6'11 guy I've seen in a long time.
Oh, yeah.
Got to have it.
I know that kid well. That's Charles Midland, Jr.
You coached his dad, right? At St. John's?
Yep, and he has been a good player for the Zags for 3 years now. Big, strong guard. Oh, good hands.
You know, the double team came late on Patricia. They waited for him to put it on the floor, the second bounce. But another speed play made out of Woolridge. Well, if you're Todd Golden right now for USF, you're thinking that the speed of four and white already a problem for us in this building.
Well, when I'm coaching San Francisco right now,
okay,
we don't want to get into a track meet with these guys. We want to make sure we can be solid in the half court. Don't turn it over and try to keep this crowd from being a big factor early. Look at this. That's running. That's a fast break. What a block.
That's your guy Minlin on the hustle.
Yeah. Boy, did they get out quick, and Minlin just got back there just as quick. Yes.
They have to have it. I think they got to get to double figure threes to hang in this ball game. Talking about San Francisco. There they are, just punching you at the paint, man. In transition, Fran, it's a kind of a non-negotiable for Mark Few in this building. Your bigs have to run and be physical. Patricia, one of them. 8-8 early. The kennel is hot. I'm sweating.
San Francisco hanging with the Zags 8-8, and part of the reason they are tied is because of Charles Midland Jr. I had a chance to coach his daddy back at St. John's in the late 90s. There we are a couple years ago at a basketball clinic, and young Charles, now a redshirt junior. His dad, a pharmacy major, played around the world. Jimmy, one of the toughest guys I've ever coached, a great Big East player and one of St. John's all-time best.
Well, he can really score. He's taken 28-29% of his team's shots, which leads that area right now. And this is a kid that will rebound. He talked with us yesterday about trying to impact the game with toughness on the boards as well. And now with Lowell out of the game with foul trouble, all those guards are going to have to get involved in the fight. And Minlin can shoot the ball at a pretty high clip, 30% on the year. But his release is better than that. Fran, you and I talked about it in practice yesterday. You look at the numbers of USF the last five games, but when you watch them in practice, it all comes off their wrist, like pure, like you think it's going in. There's not a bad stroke out there.
Yeah.
And if you're Mark Few, you know, you're looking at that more than you're looking at the percentages.
He told us last week when we talked to him on the phone, he's really worried about these San Francisco guards. Not a lot of people have stayed with the Zags in conference play, but as you mentioned earlier, the Dons led most of that game in San Francisco a couple weeks ago. Watch how they get to the basket. This is that spread offense we talked about.
You got Gonzaga, man. They try to fight you and keep that ball on the side. They're trying to protect those elbows pretty well right now. Just forcing tough shots. Got to go up.
Jimmy, one thing that's happened in this game that happened in the first game is Jimbo Lowe has picked up two quick fouls. This is a guy that averages 12 points a game. Mark Few compared him to Omar Samhan, who was a terrific player at St. Mary's. And he thought he would give him a problem tonight. But again, second time they've played, he's out of the game early.
Yeah, he's 7 foot, 255, 60 pounds, can bang inside. And the game has now changed. USF's going to have to spread that floor out and drive and make threes with him on the bench. Sometimes it works.
That'll work. They'll take what they can get here. I like the kids who bank it in and don't even change their expression.
Yeah, he's so good at that early post-up. Good grief. Fran again, the commitment for Gonzaga to run the floor with their bigs right in front of the rim. And if their bigs run out in front of the play, you are in trouble tonight if you're San Francisco. Good drive, huh, by Mendel. Man, what a tough body that he's got, first of all.
Look how fast, look at these guys get up the floor. Good challenge. I like the effort of the Don so far. This is a team that's working on its fourth straight 20-win season. There's Mendel again. Boy, does he look like his dad.
Well, those guards coming in to rebound. Mendel, just a tough, hard-nosed competitor. And expect Gonzaga, like if you're Mark Few right now, you're thinking, man, just pound this thing in the paint. That's who we are. You walk the hallways in this building and see the jerseys of guys in the NBA and the former All-Americans. All those last names are a bunch of dudes. Sabonis, Clark, Hachimura, Olynyk, Karnowski, Collins, Turioff. That is who they are, and that's who they're going to stay. So, Fran, I believe this. I saw Gonzaga in Atlantis for three games. I don't think they ever have a bad game because they throw the ball around the rim. They're
yes.
not relying on their jumpers. They're not relying on some type of finesse system. They're a body blow team, which I think keeps them from having really poor games.
Yeah, and one of the things, you know, we talked about Petrushev, and think about this, Jimmy. Last year as a freshman, look at he went against practice every day. Brandon Clark, Tilly, and Rui Hachimura.
Yeah.
That's a good cut right there.
It's a good job by San Francisco of making Gonzaga finished over the top of their length. Now, they gave up some bulk when Lowell went to the bench, but they still have length at 6'9 and 6'9 at that 4 and 5 spot.
Well, I thought, throw it back to Bouye. Take him. Take him.
He's calling for a ball screen.
Yeah, no, he had the opportunity to iso him.
Oh, nice.
Oh, Shabazz.
That's a slip with a basketball as well as you can do it. Yeah, I don't like pulling the guy up with a ball screen when you're isolated like that. Just go. Oh, watch this release.
That's money. Yep. He's such a difference maker. I think what's helped Gonzaga, Jimmy, is Drew Timmy has had to get a lot of minutes this year because Tilly's been out. Timmy's come on as one of the best freshmen in this league. You get Timmy going inside. That's pretty good.
And what can Killian Tilly not do with the basketball? He's driven it with power. He's driven it with a little bit of speed. The trail three is always a problem against Gonzaga. The push, the trail, release, rotation, result, Zags up one early.
ESPN and on the ESPN app. Number one Baylor hosts number three Kansas at the Ferrell Center in a blockbuster boom. Sonic blockbuster. This one will help decide the Big 12 title and the number one overall seed in the NCAA tournament. And Jimmy, boy, is that going to be, that's going to be awesome. Kansas was handled easily by Baylor that first meeting, something that Scott Drew had never won in Allen Fieldhouse. Jared Butler was terrific. I got a feeling Kansas has more offensive weapons this time around.
You know, I saw Baylor early against Arizona, and they're terrific. Don't get me wrong, but they don't wow me. They don't think they wow you when you break down their tape, but they're so good defensively. Those guards are just a handful, all four of them. There's a lot of pressure, I think, on Gillespie on the inside in that game. But think about this. Davion Mitchell, is that his name?
Davion Mitchell.
Davion Mitchell and Vital are two of the best individual defenders in all of college ball on the same team.
And Gillespie,
you know, yeah.
All three of those guys are tremendous. I would tell you on the other side of the coin, they can go back and get it as long as he saves it. Kansas has three of the best defenders in the country. Ndoka, Zabuki, Dotson.
And Garrett.
And Marcus Garrett, who I think is the best defender in college basketball.
Hey, I want to do something here. For about the next minute, we said it's going to be a little different feel of a broadcast. Let's just lay out and watch for about a minute of the clock. You're Mark Few for this next minute, and I'm going to be Todd Golden. And when we come back after a minute, let's kind of think about what they might be processing. Let's just watch.
Yep. Here's what I think right now. If I'm Mark Few, I continue to pound the ball inside to Timmy and Tilly. Take a look now. That last post move, Timmy, by the freshman was tremendous.
And if I'm Todd Golden, I like the fact that Gonzaga is having to finish over my length. And on that last offensive possession, I think this, we can drive these dudes.
Yeah.
We can spread them out and we can drive the ball, force a collapse and knocks down some threes. Spread them out and drive them. There you go.
There it is.
Spread them out, drive it, kick, bam. And Todd Golden has to be thinking the same thing.
Yes. And if I'm Mark Few, this is something he told us about. Their defense is not yet good enough to win a national championship.
No.
And you've seen in a couple bits and pieces why.
And guarding the ball. I think it starts with guarding the ball for Gonzaga.
Yes. I think the one good perimeter defender is the guy right here, Woolridge.
Just almost go to five out right now. Spread him and drive him. Drive and kick, play off 2 feet.
Tilly did a good job there, staying engaged. That's good defense.
Yeah, absolutely, by Tilly.
Yep.
He's 6'11", guarding a 6'1 guard. Stayed down, used his length, backed up a little bit.
And you know the story about Killian Tilly. This is great footwork. Now, if you think he's an athlete, he should be. Mom and dad, Olympic volleyball players. His dad is the coach of the French national volleyball team. And his older brother, Kevin, was an All-American at Cal Irvine. That is a really good athlete. Did you call him a 6'10 guard before?
That's what he is.
We just got a chance to see that.
Yeah. I was talking to Edmond Gilder. I saw him back in the Bahamas, but, you know, a kid I saw in the SEC a lot. One of the first things he said to me today was what surprised him the most when he got here, how good of an athlete and how fast Killian Tilly is. Nice take by Rettino. Wow.
He's a tough kid. Good defender. Not shooting it as well this year. Kid out of De La Salle High School. A great program in the East Bay.
Grand, the Dons are on an 8-0 run. And I think they're smelling blood right now driving that basketball. And this guy, Todd Golden, he's probably out in front of the analytical charts as much as anybody in college ball right now, almost to an extreme. And he attacks mismatches, and I think he feels like he can drive from three or four spots.
Well, he was confident yesterday when we watched practice. Look at his speed now. I thought it was a foul right there. I'm Mark Few. I'm not complaining.
Yeah,
but if you're Todd Golden, you better get up
absolutely.
And start getting into that referee's.
He is, and he's going to continue. Look at him right now. He's fighting for his guy's life. There's a lot of contact, and you can go straight up and throw up a wall inside that restricted arc. I'm with you. I thought there's a lot of contact right there.
You know, it looks that looks like verticality, but
it's
to
not.
Me, he's going
moving.
Sideways.
Absolutely is.
What I love about Todd Golden, not only his confidence he had, but even that moment right there, you have to fight for your team.
Sure.
Especially when you're on the road in a place like this.
I'm telling you, they are driving in all five spots. Gonzaga has had three straight turnovers. They need to pound this thing inside and get this game settled down a little bit.
Here comes a little high-low. Let's see. See, they're going to let Petrushev. Yeah, they're going to back off of him.
Yeah, there's a lot of contact on that play, was there not?
Yeah. I used to tell officials in a situation like this when I was an underdog, if we're good enough to win, I want to win this game.
Let us win.
It's too early, but Todd Golden's got to fight for his team. I love the organization of the way he slowed this game down. And to your point, try to get some dribble penetration.
Yeah,
yes.
they're just sizing Gonzaga up and playing ball right now. Keeping it simple, attacking a mismatch, feeding confidence for the shooters. Look at the double team, man. Just the quickness is eating Gonzaga up on their home floor, friend. Mark Few's got his hands full right now in that Gonzaga huddle. Number two team in the country, 26-1. Team from San Francisco Bay Area came to ball. San Francisco having success early up 23-16. They're just playing a lot of isolation ball, getting a mismatch and attacking it. Just a couple of possessions to go. Khalil Shabazz, who had 32, by the way, against BYU. This is a guy that comes in off the bench wired to score. They're attacking the mismatch. The guards are playing with freedom, dancing with the ball, rising in fire and attacking gaps. And I sure Todd Golden had some good words out of his for his guys in the huddle. Fran, you're over there. What was he talking about?
I asked him, what do you like so far? He goes, we're winning.
The score.
But more importantly, he said, we're clogging the paint. We're doing a good job of gapping and getting into the paint and causing a lot of havoc. And he's got to really like the way his team's played so far. This is a well-coached team. Of course, Kyle Smith did a great job here before he left for Washington State, and they just elevated a terrific young coach.
And now Killian Tilly on the bench. He's 3 out of 4 from the field, and the rest of the team's only 4 out of 15. Somebody's got to get going for Gonzaga.
Yeah, I love that last set. Gonzaga, when you're down, you start to extend the defense, and they took advantage of it with a great back cut.
Petrucha, just
he's got
hard,
tricks.
He's a hard guard, yeah.
He's got tricks.
You get on one side, he'll spin off of you. You're fronting, he'll walk you up. You play behind, he'll crab walk back into you. He's got all the stuff now.
Jimmy, he spent 2 years in Spain working with a coach that worked with some great big guys when he was 15 and 16. Those are the tricks he learned in Spain.
So now the backup five guy has 2 fouls on him as well, Yurkutsun. Very patient. That double came. They didn't come that time, Fran. Yeah, they didn't come on the double. I think you got to keep coming. Keep coming on him.
What I loved about that by Petrushev is he took his body and he stuck it right into the chest of the defender and backed him off.
That offense continues to be spread, playing in space. Good movement off the ball.
I love these hands of the Dons. They are active. Don't leave him open.
Went in twice, came out once. Right now, man, final four teams. They just sit down and guard and get a stop.
Well, on the other hand, I love the patience of this team. They don't take bad shots. That's a foul.
Yeah, you had to tag the roll guy that time. Gonzaga did with a guard.
Jimmy
S came in, but watch this is the watch Petrucha, Fran. He's, like you said, the patience to bound, chest, boom. The double team doesn't come. I just don't think you can do that if you're San Francisco. All right. Let's lay out again. I'm going to be Golden again, and you be Mark Few for about 45 seconds. Just kind of gather our thoughts.
The next chance I get to talk to my team at that 4 minute mark, my team's too anxious right now. Good speed. That's a rare time tonight in the last few minutes that we've been able to get him going. But in the half court, if I'm Mark Few, Jimmy, they're too anxious to make plays in the half court. They're forcing it. They're not taking advantage of transition, and they're jamming it into a good defense.
And if I'm Todd Golden, what I'm concerned with was that last defensive transition play, because I'm telling my guys, look, your half-court defense has been good enough. You've held the nation's highest-scoring team to 20 points on their home floor. If we can get our defense set, we're good. I keep talking to them about when to double Petrushev and when not to. The Dons up 5. What a game in the kennel.
Here, a place that's very difficult for WCC teams to play. And Jimmy, I love the way they've controlled the tempo. They haven't taken very many bad shots, and they are playing fearlessly.
Oh man, miss it right at the rim. Another great possession though, Fran, by San Francisco out of a timeout. Empty the corner, got a strong baseline drive, just couldn't finish.
Here's the patience I want to see now from Gonzaga.
Look how they're backing off of Timmy.
And we got Jimbo Lowe back in the game with two fouls. And I like this. Todd Golden has not fouled his big man out of the first half. He's bringing him back. He picked up the two fouls in the first 5 minutes. And he's going to play him now down the stretch. He's such a factor offensively. I don't know how you feel about it, but I'm an advocate of playing a guy with two fouls in the first half, especially if he's experienced.
Yeah, and Todd told us one thing he loves about his team. They are a high IQ group. So I think Lowell understands how to play through foul trouble right now. His name is James Lowell. My name is James Dykes. We had a great conversation. He said his dad started calling him Jimbo when he was little, talking about Jimbo Lowell. I'm thinking about going that for the rest of the year. If not Jimbo, I'm thinking about going with Jimmer. I would be a better Jimmer.
You know the best thing I do with my boys?
What's that?
I gave them nicknames.
Watch out.
I got that. I got you covered. Jimbo Lowell might be the tallest surfer in America. He grew up.
You know how he got ready for the season? He climbs mountains with a weighted vest on. And that's
pretty
a
good
side guy, right? Don't let him lull you to sleep, because he can go for a double-double if you do. Hard shot.
Yeah, tough shot, no question.
Well, they go, don't they?
This is what I've talked about. They're a little tense, Gonzaga, and you can tell they're trying to make the home run play. The Zags down by five. We're going to break in the kennel. Mark Few trying to figure it out.
Play-by-play guys, and there's Carl Ravitch telling us that nobody is listening. He is reading a heck of a book, by the way.
That's The Film Doesn't Lie by Jimmy Dykes.
Now, how about Jason Benetti? You don't want me coaching, do you? No, because he got nine X's up there and five O's. No, Jason, we do not.
I don't know about you, Jimmy, but this is easy. This job is easy. Now, let's explain. The spicy shrimp flatbread over at the Davenport, a great hotel in downtown Spokane. But I don't know about you, but do we really need a play-by-play guy the rest
of
the year?
Yes, we do. We're going to make it through tonight. But how about of all the games for us to get, we've got like 11 guys from international countries. We've
names.
Been practicing last names. Booyah, not Booyah.
Reitman
instead of Reitman.
Yep.
A few instead of Fyaw.
It's been a fun couple days in Spokane.
Wow.
Getting to hang out with two great groups of kids.
Yeah, our boss, David Seisler, flew all the way out here to keep an eye on you and I. Two eyes, actually. How about the lunch today we had?
We enjoyed that, didn't we? We had lunch with Mark Few at Jack and Dan's, which is a place owned by John Stockton's dad forever. It's an institution in Spokane. And who showed up halfway through lunch?
The greatest point guard of all time, John Stockton.
Yep.
And even at lunch, it was never about John Stockton. That's who he was as a player.
Oh, man.
That's who he is when he's retired. A humble, humble star is John Stockton.
I felt like I was in Cooperstown. Oh, they're getting, see, I love this. They are giving those big guys a shot at the top of the key. They are not letting that ball in the paint. They are daring Timmy and Petrushev to shoot that ball.
Yeah.
Tilly will make it, so they got to guard him. Let's see what Jimbo can do.
He finds the backside of the play.
Yeah. Oh, that was close.
Everything but in, wasn't it? There's our lunch right there with Coach Few. Talk about another humble star. That's Mark Few. He probably has life balance for a head coach at this level, down pat, as well as anyone in the country. Anyone in the country.
I think, Jimmy, in many ways, he's got the best job in the country. And he's never leaving here.
Yeah, Kispert shook himself out of the ball. You know, that's the one thing other than Woolridge and really, other than Woolridge, I a little bit can go by and create closeouts for others. They're such a high-skilled passing team, shooting team, but just making a play, man, is not Gonzaga's strength.
Well, I'll tell you what stands out to me so far. When you get into conference play and you play a team a second time, you almost feel like the Dons are in exactly the same spots that the Zags are. And that's that familiarity, that neighborhood rivalry.
Oh, wow, what a play by Tilly. He felt the defensive help coming on his right side, so instead of spinning back, he stays with his left.
He's the one guy I don't think you can let drive from the top.
No, you cannot.
The other two guys, I'm fine with. They did a good job in practice yesterday fronting the post here. That's Petrushev.
Boy, Dons are fighting on those boards now. Wow, they came to fight when that ball's on the glass. And that's when the war begins. I was at the game back in Atlantis when Gonzaga and Michigan played in the finals. 25 points was there scored halftime. Look at the yellow jerseys banging that's NBA length, friend.
I love Kuhn and this kid. This kid, here's the drive. Watch this. He's the one guy of the bigs that Todd Golden told his team, we don't want him getting going.
Such a great feel, man.
I love this kid, man. I'm a little partial because of his dad, but he's got the same type of toughness. His dad was a little bit bigger, and he got fouled on that play.
Friend, again, think about this. The low for Gonzaga in the first half is 25 points. That was all the way back in November at Battle for Atlantis. That's how good San Francisco's defense has been in this game.
Wow. That's great effort. This is stunning to me, but on the other hand, we've been watching film of these guys, and Todd Golden, the youngest coach in this league, former player at St. Mary's, there's a reason they elevated him. This team plays with poise.
The last time Gonzaga was held below 83 points was November 29th in the Battle for Atlantis, and they ain't even close to tracking that right now. The speed in yellow is faster than the speed in white on this floor at about all five spots.
Hey, coming up at the half, we'll join Kevin Connors, Dallin Cuff, and Sean Farnham, who will be in Provo for the Zags and BYU Saturday night for the E-Trade Halftime Report. Can't wait to hear what Dallin and Sean think of this first half. By the way, Kevin Connors was a pretty good college point guard.
Was he really?
Yeah.
Well, the Zags they got to figure out their offense. I mean, their defense is not bad. You're holding a team that can get in the 80s at 29 right now, but the Zags, other than throwing it inside, they just can't get anything rolling.
I'll tell you what I like about road teams who are the underdogs is Todd Golden convinced his team yesterday and today at practice.
And they can win this game.
If we do these things, we are going to be in this game. And again, they've already played them once with a chance to win the game.
Friend, you talked about it earlier. The deflections and the hand speed of San Francisco really bothering the ball.
Yeah, Jimmy, right now, if you're analytically inclined the way they are, they probably will go 2-for-1 here, and you can't do that. So they still have a chance. Here's what I've told coaches this year. If you're going to go 2-for-1, you got to get that ball on the rim by 42. So they still have 11 seconds to get it, and Todd Golden's trying to get two possessions out of this. There it is.
Yeah, they're gonna get it back either way.
They just can't let these guys get in transition.
Nice cut.
Oh man.
Wow.
What an effort on the glass. And they're gonna get that last shot.
Yeah.
Let's see what they do.
I can tell you what's worked. It's just one-on-one isolation, sizing a guy up and making a play.
That's why I don't like ball screens here, because you can trap the ball out of a good player's hands.
Get the switch. Good job by Gilder. What a tough shot, though, by Menland. They go underneath the defensive arm of Gilder. And the clock's going to tick out on the Zags.
Jimmy, we got something brewing here, man.
Yeah, we do.
I wasn't expecting this. This is the lowest scoring first half by the Zags all season. This is the number two team in the country, and San Francisco with a terrific young team doing a great job.
The number one scoring team in the country, Gonzaga, has got a lot to figure out at halftime. The speed, the hand speed, and the foot speed of the Dons, a major story in this game. After a short break, it'll be the E-Trade halftime with Kevin Connors, Dallin Cuff, and Sean Farnham. Stay up late for this one. We got a ball game in the Kemp.
Welcome back to the Kennel in Spokane, Washington. I'm Fran Frischel along with Jimmy Dykes, and we've got a surprise brewing. The Dons of San Francisco have come in here. They've only shot 33% from the field. Their defense has been outstanding, and they lead by nine. And it's been about defense, Jimmy, and I love those guards. Watch the quick hands.
Yeah, the team speed of San Francisco has really jumped out. Sitting here live, and they've done a great job of doubling and throwing some different looks at the bigs of Gonzaga. Gonzaga's turned the ball over way too much. You know, I was talking to Gonzaga's staff as they came out of the locker room, Fran. Here's their concern with their club. They were honest with their guys. Our worst offensive performance of the year was that half. We turned it over eight times. And guys, the result, San Francisco has taken 13 more shots in this ball game. And the bottom line is, we can't keep missing two-foot shots. So the message has been sent loud and clear to Gonzaga.
Well, if I'm Todd Golden, the coach of San Francisco, I'm telling my guys, this is what we talked about. We gave you the game plan. You've only turned it over four times, and we've really made it hard for Gonzaga to score in the paint. And we've got to make sure that we continue to stay with it. Last game they played, Gonzaga trailed by eight to the same team.
Yep.
I always felt as a head coach in a situation like this, we killed ourselves to get a nine-point lead. We must be ready to play the first 4 minutes of the second half with energy and poise.
And think about how good San Francisco's defense was in the first half. They only fouled five times. So not only were they hot defensively, they were defending without fouling. Gonzaga wasn't getting to the free throw line. And Todd Golden right now, I know the Kennel is hot behind us. The energy is still high. But his team right now is in control of this ball game. And man, what a story we would have brewing. Gonzaga sitting there as a potential number one seed in the NCAA tournament, fighting for that. And Mark Few's got 20 minutes now to figure this thing out.
One thing he's got to really figure out is how to keep those three guards from getting into the paint. Because they are every bit the nightmare he told us they would be. I'm anxious to see the first play of the second half of the Zags.
It's going inside. Somehow, some way, it's going inside. Well, they did that, San Francisco, the whole first half. They're backing off that high-low action with the exception of Killian Tilly. So now Petrushev, Timmy, they've got to make some 12 and 15-foot shots and to loosen that coverage up.
If I'm Todd Golden, I tell them, let them have that shot for now.
Absolutely. They're not going to mess around now. They're going to double hard on Jimbo Lowell.
See, and I don't like this start because if I'm coaching San Francisco, I've warned my team, you killed yourself with effort to get a big lead at the half. We cannot squander it in the first 3 minutes.
The ball's going right back inside if you're Gonzaga. That's who they are.
And watch, you'll see, they'll back off Petrushev again at the top.
Double going to come. Jimbo Wall. Yeah. I know his name's Jimbo Lowell, but that was Jimbo Wall. What a terrific defensive play against one of the elite post players in the country. Keep his feet alive, a big broad base and high hands, got his elbows by his ears and didn't foul. Terrific.
Yeah. More importantly, he had two fouls and he did not want to get a third one in the first minute and a half. That's for sure. That's the experience we talked about. Oh, that's three straight possessions.
Wow.
Todd Golden would be, he's a lot calmer than I would be right now. Jimmy, I really feel this way. I watch a lot of teams, as you do during the season. I don't think teams warm up for the second half the way that I would have.
To really get their motor going and handle the ball.
Why give away a lead that you worked so hard to for 20 minutes?
Such a threat. Oh, man, another ball that went in twice and came out once.
I don't think San Francisco's gotten a shot up so far.
And the one they got off was bad. Find the backside of the play, get it up the far side. I'm fine with that shot.
It's
a wide open shot by Ayayi. Mark Few applauded it, came off the ball screen, let it go.
They went under for a reason. They dared him to shoot it.
A walk.
Yeah. He was trying to go Euro step, But he was trying to get all the way to Australia on that one. That ain't going to work. One little extra step by the freshman. He comes out of a great academy, the Center for Excellence, which has produced guys like Dellavedova, Patty Mills, Kickert, all the great players that played at St. Mary's. He's going to be a good player. Koonin, remember that name.
Gonzaga is so good at that, Fran. They interchange those two bigs to come up and set a ball screen in the middle part of the floor and then dive hard out of it. But when they dive out of the action, Fran, they dive right. They dive from here to there. I mean, they get on the backside of that rim so that ball can find the backside of the play. Good cut.
I like where I am if I'm San Francisco. The defense is still pretty solid. And I'm telling you, when you play a favorite, the closer you get to the end of the game and you're still in it, the tighter the favorite gets. Now that's two. That's
can't
too
do
good.
It. Wow! Wow! Kendall getting in the ball game, as has Gonzaga's defense to start the second half. San Francisco, 5 turnovers on 6 possessions. Gonzaga's gotten hot defensively. We talk about teams that get hot offensively. They've come out of that locker room now with a little bit more punch, a little bit more energy, active hands, active feet, trying to split a double team right there. And Killian Tilly, the athleticism of this kid, Fran, surprises me.
I don't agree. I don't think the athleticism's gotten any better. I think San Francisco's just been very sloppy.
I think Gonzaga's defensive energy is a lot better.
Yeah.
A lot better.
But that was no defensive energy there. That's just sloppy play.
Right. But I think it's both.
Yeah, but if I'm Todd Golden, I'm not worried about the Gonzaga defense. I'm worried about us executing what we did for 20 minutes. This is like a carbon copy of what they did in San Francisco. I think they've lost their poise myself.
And I think Gonzaga's staff got into their kids' butts about not defending in the first half. Either way, the ball is going to go inside for Gonzaga on offense.
Watch this possession. Will they get a good shot? I mean.
Yeah, they're being sped up a little bit. Watch
this
out.
This is trouble.
Wow, what a move. Because the double was coming, and just Patrušev so good with the feel.
But Jimbo's got to get to a point now where he's not worried about the two fouls anymore. See, Jimbo is now playing no defense.
Again, I think Gonzaga, they were so fast on the double team. They rotated out of the double team. They're trying to blow up dribble handoffs.
But Jimmy, they're not driving anymore.
No, they're not.
I just think they've lost their poise, San Francisco. I mean, you'd expect them to come out and play harder. But if I'm Todd Golden, I'm saying, hey.
Spread it, drive it.
Yeah, let's get back to what we did in the first half. Let's go, Dons.
If I'm Mark View, I'm saying, add a way to guard, boys. Add a way. Before the All-Star break, and then the playoff push starts, and these teams are in the thick of it. Our Friday night doubleheader starts in OKC with Nikola Jokic, as he told me the other night, and the Nuggets taking on Chris Paul and the Thunder at 8 Eastern, 7 Central. Then Zion, the guy known with only one name, and the Pelicans are in the Rose City for a battle with the Blazers. Our coverage starts with NBA Countdown at 7 Eastern on ESPN and the ESPN app, and John Stockton knows a little bit about that league.
There he is. What a lunch we had today with Mark Few at Jack and Dan's. John's dad's old place. And then John walked in with his youngest son, Samuel. And Jimmy, we could have talked to John Stockton for 2 hours.
When you talk about the all-time great point guards, he's got to be in the conversation, if not number one. And boy, that Gonzaga is so good, Fran. I talked about they seldom have a bad game. They didn't have a great half. They don't have bad games because they pound that thing inside. The interior passing, it all starts with a paint punch and then the hands of Tilly to finish.
If you're a coach right now, I'm going to tell you this. Your teams must practice the first 3 minutes of the second half. We used to come out, warm up hard in practice, and then figure out what we wanted to do. Jimmy, when you start the second half, you have to take care of the ball, you have to attack, get the ball inside, and you have to come up with 50-50 balls. The Dons have done none of that so far. Tough shot, quick shot, not the shot they took in the first half. That's that 50-50 rebound.
Dunk. Oh, wow.
What I love about this kid is that we mentioned it earlier. Last year, he played 11 minutes a game against two first-round picks. And has he stepped up his game? Petrushev.
His first practice as a Zag, Petrushev, he was great. But he said, I looked great, but I wasn't great because he wasn't ready for the physical blows. And they started beating on him with dummies. And now, man, that guy, he delivers blows more than absorbs blows.
This is a 12-0 run to start the second half for Gonzaga. No baskets, no points for Todd Golden's team.
When you have more turnovers than shot attempts, you're in trouble. And that's what San Francisco is tracking right now. Analytics is telling Todd Golden in his mind, this ain't good.
You know what? I coach when there weren't analytics. To me, it's about the way they came out. I'm disappointed in the effort they had.
And I'm praising Gonzaga as the number two team to turn it on.
But don't you think that was going to be a given anyway?
Well, yes and no, because, Fran, my question for Gonzaga has been, can they defend and set their butt down in a stance and defend with a purpose? And I thought they've done it this half.
Good follow-up. And I think they need to keep driving it like
Absolutely, they do.
Yeah.
Drive the pressure.
And the only way you can get that is if you take your time, spread the defense out, and not allow them to sit on your guys.
All right, let's go again. I'm going to be Mark Few for the next minute, and you be Todd Golden. Let's just watch and gather our thoughts. Let's get away from our staff, collect our own thoughts, and watch the game and kind of get the noise. Just let us absorb it for about a minute. I'm Mark, and you're Todd.
I like the last two possessions of my team for San Francisco. I don't like that we gave up the open three to Kispert off that screen that we walked through at the shoot-around, but I do like the fact that the last two possessions we said, hey, the hell with it. Let's start getting back to what we did in the first half. Drive that ball.
I love the challenge of the shot. I love us getting out and running. And I'm a big fan of Corey Kispert. He came in this ball game, Fran. The guy that just made the last three for Gonzaga, 12 out of 20 over his last four games. So now if I'm Mark Few, I'm thinking, okay, I'm giving body blows around the rim with my bigs. I got my shooter going on the outside. I got a four-point lead.
And I also know that I can score, as you said earlier, from every single position on the court. So they can run it. They can pound it. They can shoot it.
Only team in the country, I think we said in the first half, with seven guys in double figures.
Yeah.
The only team in the country. Think about that.
First time in 20 years. And I'll tell you about, I will say one thing about this Woolridge kid. You think of that, you saw him in Atlantis.
Uh-huh.
The guards he's had to guard this year, Mannion, Xavier Simpson, some of the really good guards in this league. He has really added that element, Jimmy, to the defense you talked about. Look at this.
They got him. The energy level of Gonzaga defensively. Mark, he may say at the end of this game, as good as they've been all year to start this second half. He's gone with his press, and Fran, as you know as a coach, you want to make your guys play hard, I'm going to make you get in the press. Because if you don't, you're going to get exposed.
There it is.
And Kispert is a 6'7", long guy up top, diving on the floor. This is a Gonzaga team now looking a lot more like that number one seed we thought coming in. A lot of ball game left, though.
I think the hardest thing about playing Gonzaga this season in the NCAA tournament, Jimmy, I saw number one and number three earlier in the week, Baylor and Kansas.
Yep.
Kansas scores like Gonzaga, especially lately. You have to be able to get into a tournament game with them and score 80 points if you want to beat
them. You do. Absolutely, you do.
Everybody talks about defense wins championships. I disagree. You have to score points late in the tournament in order to beat really good teams.
Watch
That's
out.
Too easy.
Bam! The kennel is barking. Gonzaga.
We're destined for greatness. Nobody.
Oh, we got a good one, man. Big Show Basketball.
A Sonic Blockbuster season continues Saturday at noon on ESPN.
There you see two of the best teams in college basketball, both projected to be number one seeds. In fact, the top two overall seeds, according to Joe Lunardi. Baylor won the first game, Jimmy. Full house at the Ferrell Center. You've been there this year. I've been there this year. But I think Kansas, to me, they've evolved since that first meeting. And Maceo Teague has not played the last two games for Baylor. He was averaging 17 points a game in the previous four. They're going to need his scoring. He's got to play on Saturday and play well.
Yeah, I mean, both those teams are two of the 15 or 20 teams that can get to Atlanta. I think there's probably 10 or 12 that can win the whole thing. Kansas, Baylor right there in that conversation. I love Seton Hall. I know you do as well. And that's going to be the most anticipated game at Waco in a long time.
Now, interesting about Killian Tilly. He's played almost 22 minutes tonight. He hasn't played in the last couple games. He's got the ankle injury. Mark Few told us today if he could get 20 good minutes out of him, he'd be happy. I think he's really happy so far.
Yeah, trying to play in five-minute segments. Petrushev and Killian with Tilly with 28 of the 40 points. 41 now.
Yeah, those two guys are tremendous offensively. Those are the shots that the Dons made in the first half.
Wow, that's just an old-fashioned gunner right there, Corey Kispert. I mean, the dead sprint to the slot by Kispert. So impressive. Work done early for a shooter.
And he doesn't get that shot if Minwin finishes like he did in the first half. 21-2 run by the Zags.
Another challenge shot.
Well, we haven't talked about Admon Gilder tonight, the A&M transfer. He comes off the bench for this team.
Man, this guy is a ball player. In the middle part of the floor at 6'11", there's no one in the college game more dangerous than 33 in white.
And
nobody.
And to amplify, they play 2-on-2 in the middle. Inside and out. Those are tough shots right here.
What are they doing now?
Well, they've lost their poise.
I go back to Tilly, Fran. He can stretch the floor for Mark Few without sacrificing length. Without sacrificing length on the floor, he stretches the floor. His gravity ability someday as a pro is off the charts in terms of you have to stay attached to him.
Yeah, here's a great example. Watch this team get up the floor. And you can't leave this guy open. Corey Kispert. I mean, this team runs. Those are the shots that the Dons made in the first half to slow that Zag breakdown.
Oh, that open corner attack.
Oh, great speed! What a play! What a game changer! Ryan Woolridge. He was all set to go to Oklahoma State until Gonzaga called him late in the spring. And they said, we need a guard like you. And Mark Few told us, Jimmy, a couple times since we've been here, it wouldn't be out of the realm of possibility he will get Player of the Year votes. When they compare him to Perkins and Santangelo and some of the great ones, you notice I didn't say Stockton.
Right.
But certainly among the great ones that have played here. Cargo, what an addition.
Bam! Number two team in the country in the second half, looking like number one. They just empty out that corner and let Corey Kispert do a little two-man game with Killian Tilly. This kid's got some pop now. He can shoot it. You got to respect Tilly. You stay attached. Opens up the corner baseline drive. Gonzaga on fire on both ends of the floor right now. Wow, what a start.
Here's what I want to ask you, Jimmy Dykes. Yep. You watch the SEC. I watch the Big 12. We cover college basketball. Does it affect Gonzaga when they get to the tournament because they're playing teams like this? And listen, this is a good team. This
right.
is a potential NIT team. But how much of them blowing teams out in the WCC does it affect them when they get to March as opposed to Kansas playing Baylor, Kentucky playing Mississippi State?
I would answer like this. They're the only team in the country over the past 5 years that go to five straight Sweet 16. It doesn't affect them. When I look at Gonzaga right now, and I'll ask you this question. I look at Gonzaga and I put them in the SEC. Could they win the SEC? Absolutely they could win it this year. Could they win the Big 12?
I think they could.
Absolutely.
I think Kansas and Baylor, to me, would give them real problems, no question.
Yep, but they'd be in the hunt.
Yeah.
They'd be in the
fight.
But
I do think this, they would definitely have more losses in the SEC or Big 12.
Right.
I don't think they would be 17-1 or... 17-1 or 16-2.
Just watch across the bottom for the next 30 seconds. All these numbers that are staggering in terms of how they compare to the Blue Bloods, Kansas, Duke, and Gonzaga.
This is a ball game, but it's going to take a lot of poise by San Francisco, and they did not have it the first 10 minutes of this half. They score here, we got a game.
Absolutely.
I'm okay with that shot.
Well, yeah, because that's who they are. They take 28 threes a game, San Francisco does, making 9 in conference play. Uh-oh. They do that 8 or 9 times a game. They set the ball screen, they come off of it, they get the shooter rising out of the corner. And again, all five guys are weapons for the Zags.
You know, that kid shot 30% at North Texas.
That's something.
And he's in the mid-40s here. And you know what you love about this? This is great back action. Watch this. The ball's going to come off, and here comes Woolridge out of the corner because his man has got to guard inside until he can get back out to it. We call that back action. That man comes out of the corner. Great basketball right there. Come off a pick and roll, throw it behind you. And if you don't throw it behind, that's because the big guy's open at the rim.
Gonzaga will do that in transition, Fran. They'll throw it to the wing, throw it up top, and throw it right back to the wing. They're so good at getting their bigs in position and just playing right through that touch.
See, I like that.
Shot.
That's who they
absolutely.
Are.
Absolutely. Made a hard shot. If I'm Mark Few, I'm okay with that. You threw a wall up, the kid made a hard shot on you.
Too sloppy.
Watch behind.
Woolridge. Wow.
Had a chance to make it a 51-44 game, and Woolridge, the speed, has changed the year probably for Gonzaga.
I think as good as the big guys are, he's the difference maker for this team. I don't know if you could go into the NCAA tournament and not have an electric guard like that against the type of teams you're going to see. Mark Few says he and Gilder are the two most introverted guys he's coached at Gonzaga. They don't say boo.
Khrushchev took a shot where you don't want to take a shot. I'm going to go listen to Todd Golden's timeout because they're in this game with under 7 to go.
Cisco led at the half. Gonzaga has roared back in the last 13 minutes. Jimmy Dykes, my partner, is hanging around that huddle trying to get that final word from the coaching staff. And WCC, what a great season it has been. Tracking towards three teams in the NCAA tournament. So far, BYU with Yoey Childs coming back. And while we were away, they were reviewing a play on Philip Petrushev, and they have ruled that the activity caused by Khalil Shabazz was incidental contact. Mark Few gets the explanation. And I think Jimmy has left me to do play-by-play. By the way, this is not as hard a job as everybody says it is. And Jimmy's gonna get some more insight. And they have given Petrushev and Timmy those shots all night. Backed off and played him. And the key now for San Francisco is out of a timeout. Can they get a good look? And you see a foul there on Ryan Woolridge, the graduate transfer from North Texas. My broadcast partner Jimmy Dykes is back. Jimmy, you loitered there.
I did loiter.
What did you get?
Well, a couple of things. First of all, for a 34-year-old head coach, very poised. He listened to all four assistants, got some numbers, sat down in front of his guys. At the end of the day, he wants to speed the game up. He's like, we got to start playing fast. Speed this thing up, be aggressive, attack every switch you can, and start playing as fast as we can get this game going right now. But, I was really surprised by how calm for a young guy that he was in that huddle.
Yeah, and I think what he's trying to get him to do, we call this having a comeback offense. You know, you can play deliberately for a while. They did in the first half. But now at this point of the game, you do have to have a comeback offense that allows you to drive it and score it quickly.
How about the defense by Petrushev? He's a 6'11 guy taking on a 5'11 guard. Kept his butt down, moved his feet high, hands very well done.
Got a mismatch inside. Here it is.
You see Petrushev go to the backside of the play. Man, so good at reading that ball in flight.
Those are the shots you need to make. But I like the offense. I like playing quickly like that. You're down like this, you must take some chances.
Just Petrushev just sat there that time. It was kind of a short roll, and he just hung out. He just hung out that short roll area. And
bad backside defense as well. Bad. No rotation.
Killian Tilly and Petrushev, they don't fumble the ball, man. They got terrific set of paws.
Well, what you're seeing is two kids that are international players that know how to play the game. And when you think of Gonzaga through the years, starting with Roni Turiaf under Mark Few, they have gotten kids like this year after year after year. 17 different countries have worn Gonzaga uniforms since Mark Few took over, besides the U.S.
It started with Roni Turiaf, right?
He was the
first
one
of the
pioneer.
First good ones.
Yep. Yeah. You know, they had Australians in the past. Axel Dench was the last one that was on that Elite Eight team in 99, but Roni Turiaf took a chance and came to Spokane because of this guy, Tommy Lloyd, who's the head coach in waiting and has turned down many jobs. But Tommy is as well connected as there is an assistant coach around the world. He knows everybody. Remember today we went to the office?
Yeah, he had a guy. Lithuanian there, right?
Yeah.
You know what? With the Zags, there are no boundaries. There are no recruiting boundaries. He can go get Drew Timmy, who everybody in the country wants out of Dallas, and he can get guys from Bosnia or wherever. There are no recruiting boundaries for Gonzaga.
Saturday at noon Eastern on ESPN and the ESPN app. Number one Baylor, the Bears are hosting Kansas at the Ferrell Center in Waco in a Sonic blockbuster. This one should help decide the Big 12 title and number one overall seed in the NCAA tournament. By the way, Jimmy, it's almost impossible for me to think that both of those teams will not be number one seeds regardless. I don't think they're going to lose five or six in a row. As you see, they tend to Killian Tilly for a second.
Yeah, that number one and two seed, that's a battle right now. So you know what? What's the West Coast version of my jet? It took me three stops to get here yesterday, but here we are. Gonzaga and San Diego State right now would be in first class as potential number one seeds. I think they'll hold on. Oregon's going to be a three or a four seed. I love that team. Peyton Pritchard, one of the guys I would love to coach in college ball. Arizona, BYU, St. Mary's, Southern Cal. Solidly in coach. Utah State holding on right now. Back there in the back of the plane by the blue water, and
I'll tell you one thing,
the middle seat, but they can play now.
I'll tell you one team you're missing.
Who's that?
The Sun Devils tonight. Smoke
Arizona
Oregon.
State.
Yeah,
they could go off the standby list then.
Yeah, no, I think they're going to be in your coach seating soon.
Okay.
Now let's take a look at this, and let's just leave that up there for a second. You talked about it. No boundaries. International players. They come here. They have success. Why? The style of play. The comfort level. The transfers and the graduate transfers. Getting a kid like Adam Morrison out of Spokane, the regional recruiting, and then the top 100 guys like Drew Timmy. They have figured out a formula here at Gonzaga over the last 20 years that Jimmy has been nearly flawless.
You know, Fran, on the transfers, like, they don't miss. They get it right. The guys they bring in and that transfer, they go through that recruiting process and they ask the hard questions. And if you're not going to fit and do it the Zag way, then you're out. And Mark Few and his guys have just done a terrific job of bringing guys in that have gotten it done.
I can think of Dan Dickow last year, Brandon Clark. How about the guy you saw in Kentucky, Kyle Wilcher?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Micah Downs, Errol Knight back in the day. In the way basketball is in college right now, you and I know this. You can't really build. There you go. Is that Brooke Stepp?
Yeah, it is.
Brooke Stepp. Yeah, I remember Brooke from back in the day. Very smart, hard-nosed guard. But here's the thing. College basketball's changed. You are now. That guy was pretty good.
Yeah.
You are now a roster management supervisor. You're like a GM now.
Yeah. Boy, look at Woolridge just completely trying to delete a drive. He had to fight for the basket that time. Did Midland. It's still a ball game now.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely it is.
Got to get a stop here. You know what? That was a 21-2 run by Gonzaga, and the Dons have battled back. Give them credit.
Gonzaga, the highest scoring team in the country, 83 a game. All right, now they have 56. A horrible first half. Second half is more what we've seen of the Zag. Look at Tilly just waiting on that double team to not come. Bam.
Oh, man.
How hard is he to guard, man? Good grief. He breaks the press with pressure on him. He can bring it with speed and transition in the middle part of the floor. He is a nightmare. They can win it all with him. They can't win it all without him if he doesn't stay healthy.
I think their defense still has to get better against elite teams. That's my one concern. They're 35 right now. And I think Mark Few knows it. I think that start of the second half was a good move in the right direction. Here's your boy.
33 in white. Is that Larry Bird?
Saturday night, this highly anticipated rematch is finally happening. Wilder Fury 2. Their first fight was an epic split draw in December of 2018. Now Deontay Wilder defends his WBC heavyweight title for a record 11th time against the lineal champ Tyson Fury. Wow, is he a piece of work. 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, live on pay-per-view and ESPN Plus. To order the main card, go to ESPNplus.com/top rank and be sure to download the ESPN app if you're watching on your mobile device. They did an E60 on Tyson Fury, young man from England. Emotionally challenged, Jimmy. He's back on the right track, and that will be epic Saturday night in Vegas.
Yeah, you and I have known Mark Few for a long time. I would challenge anyone out there to say who has a better culture from head coach to manager than Mark Few. Think about this. In the past 22 years, there's only been six guys total that were academic All-American and All-American. Gonzaga's had three of those six. Think about that. So they touch all the bases. Dan Dickow, Kelly Olynyk, and Nigel Williams-Goss were All-Americans and academic All-Americans. That is outstanding culture in this program.
Nigel Williams-Goss definitely doesn't surprise me. He turned down Tommy Amaker and Harvard
yeah.
to go to Washington to play for Lorenzo Romar, and then finished here, took the Zags team to a Final Four. We said it earlier, but I'll say it again. Mark Few, if you add all the things up besides making a ton of money, I think he's got the best job in college basketball.
You look at Todd Golden right now. He's going to that fouling on purpose in the backcourt.
Yep.
Trying to play the percentage, trying to play the analytics. He knows the numbers. He's going to gamble right now and say, can you make two? And I'm coming down to try to make three.
And he's done it twice so far. You know this. He did it at BYU. Yoli Childs missed.
And it's going to pay. It could pay off right here.
Yep. He did it against Pacific in the first half. The last time I saw somebody foul a player on purpose in the first half, Rick Barnes did it to Stevie Thompson back in 1988.
Well, Todd Golden knows that he's put Woolridge, a 60% free throw shooter, on that line. I expect it to continue, knowing how young and aggressive this guy is with his numbers.
Well, he's got to make sure Woolridge has the ball.
Yeah, you can't do that.
Can't do that. Won't matter if he fouls him or not. There it is. Had a chance to give it. Didn't give it.
Got that emptied out corner for Gilder to attack. What a pass.
Yep.
Making a play out of the corner. Ryan Woolridge.
You realize Admon Gilder led Texas A&M to a Sweet 16, and he comes off the bench and averages double figures.
I think Gonzaga's done a great job of challenging shots in the second half. There's been a hand in the face of every San Francisco shot in the second 20 minutes. Fran, I had a question coming in about Gonzaga. Is their point guard good enough to win the national championship? When I consider Devon Dodson, Jared Butler, Jalen Crutcher, Trey Jones at Duke, the Hagans kid at Kentucky, Pritchard at Oregon, I've answered that question. This kid's good enough to win one with.
I think he is, but I have to tell you, they're playing San Francisco tonight and not Kansas, you know, not some of the elite teams. I still wonder, Jimmy, if the defense right now is good enough to beat the elite teams. They did it in the second half tonight. You saw them in Atlantis against good teams.
Yes.
They lost to a good Michigan team. And I think Tilly played in that game.
Yes, he did.
Where are they better now than they were back in November? Is it the defense?
To me, it's the defense, Fran.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were just not connected yet. I mean, you look at it was only the third or fourth game they played together as a unit. So I they continue to grow in terms of how to get the ball inside, and now they got seven guys in double figures. I think back in Atlantis they only had five. So this might be a year, as you know, it's so wide open. If I have to gamble on something in that bracket, I'm going to gamble on offense, like you said earlier.
Yeah, I would say this, and I think Mark Few made this point to us. Well, and I looked this up, and then I told him about this. Since 2002 in the Ken Palm era, the national champion has had no lower than an 18th rated defense, and that was North Carolina in 2009, where they didn't have to play any defense and they still would have won it. Right now, Gonzaga's 34. It can climb and get better, because guess what? When you beat teams in the NCAA tournament, that defensive efficiency is going to keep dropping.
Yeah.
I think offensively, man, they've got it.
Mark Few telling his guys, you know they're coming at you. Be strong with the ball. Close the game out right now. Well, we'll find out more about Gonzaga Saturday night at the Marriott Center. BYU is a real team.
I love them.
Yoli Childs is a grown man, yep. And that place is going to have 21, 22,000 in there. You and I have
been in there
before.
I coached in there. Man.
That's a must-watch game Saturday night between Gonzaga and BYU. What a performance by 33 in white.
He played more than 20 minutes tonight. He got his money's worth. He's been nursing that ankle injury. The key for Mark Few now is to keep this young man healthy between now and early April.
Fran, he made his last 7 field goals in this game. So the condition that Mark Few is concerned with, he answered the bell, he rang the bell and then played through it because you know he is tired the last 4 or 5 minutes. So to make his last 7 made field goals, that's a really good sign for Mark Few and Gonzaga.
This league is heading towards 3 teams in the tournament. St. Mary's, BYU has a terrific offensive team, man. You mentioned Yoli Childs, 12 double-double tonight. They can score the ball. How about this? They lead the country in 3-point shooting. Wow.
E. Joel as well. For Fran, I was blown away last Wednesday. The Lakers at the Nuggets, my first NBA game. The size on the floor can overwhelm you when you don't watch it on a regular basis.
Yeah.
And the spacing that went along with the size.
What'd you think of Jokic? Because there are some people that think he's not athletic.
No.
And that dude is 7 feet. I saw him as an 18-year-old in Prague. I didn't think he was this good, but he's the point guard.
He has lost 50 pounds.
Yeah.
He's lost 50 pounds in about the last 6 months. A 7-foot passing, just a gee-whiz passer. A high, high-level game, and that just... Edmond Gilbert came up to me today. The first thing he said was, hey, how was that Lakers-Nuggets game? That's what these dudes want to talk about.
25% of the NBA right now was born outside the United States. You look at Gonzaga, you look at San Francisco, the basketball globe has shrunk. When you think of all these Zags and all the great players that have come through here from places like France and Serbia and Australia, New Zealand, those two guys.
Can I clean something up for all of college basketball?
Yeah.
There's 2 things that drive me nuts.
It's only?
Only 2. It's Gonzaga. You and I have said it right all year long. It's not Gonzaga. It's Gonzaga, and it's Calipari, not Calipari.
If you take
nothing else away from this game tonight, it's Gonzaga and Calipari.
Hey, Jimmy, in 1978, I worked Dean Smith's basketball camp. My roommate was some fast-talking guy from Pittsburgh.
Watch out.
You're good. I got you.
I got ran over one time by a kid from Alabama.
My roommate was a guy named John Calipari.
That's
42 years ago.
He make his bed?
All he cared about was money and winning.
Nothing's changed.
You got it.
And he's done a lot of both since you were roommates back at that camp.
Who wins a neutral court game between Kentucky and Gonzaga?
Wow, that's I'm telling you what, if they play 10 times, I think it's 5-5. I really do. Because Kentucky's guards, man, they can get after you, but they're not going to back down from these guys. And the front line, Nick Richards against Patrushev and E.J. Montgomery against Timmy, and that's a ball game. That's a 5-5. Plus, I got Kentucky in the SEC tournament.
Well, yeah.
I don't see a lot of their fans.
Yeah, Twitter will blow up tonight if you didn't say 5-5.
I really feel that way, though. I really do.
Yeah, you know, I'm actually not sure. I can't tell you whether Kansas or Baylor are better than this team.
Yeah, absolutely.
I can't.
Yeah.
You know, I could make a guess, but it's been fun, James.
Absolutely, my friend. Yeah. Thank you for our boss, David Seister, let us come out here. The kennel was so fun early. Maybe the highlight of my year so far was dancing with the kids.
My pet peeve here is don't take a violation. Get a shot off.
Yeah, get a shot off.
Yeah. I don't. Why give one of your players on the court a turnover for no reason? Get a shot up. There you go. I like that.
There you go.
Yeah. Not rubbing it in. Just playing good basketball.